ZNS Total Sports, brought to you by Fourth Terrace Diagnostic Center.
Welcome to sports, everybody. The 12th annual Bull Reds Class C Regatta got underway earlier today in Georgetown, Exuma. Competition on the water will resume again on Saturday, but prior to that, a special ceremony will take place on Friday night.
7 p.m. at the Resource Center, we will have a gala banquet where we will be honoring 30 persons who have made significant contribution not only to Regatta or Bull Reds Regatta, but Regatta on the whole. Take, for example, we have Basil Mintz. He has some photos from 1954 when Regatta first started. The founding person, Linton Riggs, and the governor, and it's some outstanding photos that we want people to see.
Now, at the ceremony on Friday night, Regatta consultant and owner of the ASU Drua WG Thunderbird, the Reverend Dr. Philip McPhee, will also be recognized, mostly for being a good sport.
He's a rev. He can take the beating, you know. He will not get angry. He will not get mad. Tomorrow he would smile it off and it would be the same thing. And so he's a good sportsman. He loved the sport of sloop sailing. And of course, he loved Exuma and support the Bull Reds Regatta tremendously. And so we like to beat up on the rep. Somebody have to lose. And of course, somebody have to win. It so happens my boat, which is Golden Girl, normally is amongst the winners.
I know Golden Girl is an exceptional good boat. She is certainly now the boat to watch for. And so we're going to see what we can do. We're going to see if we can handle her. We did it before, and we can do it again.
Now, following the Bull Reds Regatta, it will be on to South Andrews for another Class C Regatta during their majority rule holiday weekend. And that also promises to be a competitive few days of sailing.
Wherever there's history, I want to be there. And I let them know that we will certainly come and share in the celebration on majority rule for a celebration in South Andrews, a historic place, Sir Lyndon Pendleton's area. And we'll go there and bring home Sir Lyndon Pendleton back to the Bahamas, to NASA, and certainly to the McPhee's house and to my sponsor's shelf, if that's what they want. The more beating I put on Kevin, the more he wants. So if he needs some more, well, we'll start off the year by putting something on him that will last him for 12 long months.
Well, Ken Gibson, a three-time national chess champion, won the 2013 edition of the Bahamas Blitz Championship, held last weekend at the C.W. Sawyer Primary School Auditorium. The tournament attracted some 19 players of all ages and skill level. Current national champ Kendrick Knowles led the field most of the way before finishing up in second. Now, with the conclusion of the Blitz Championship, the Bahamas Chess Federation closed out a successful 2013 calendar, which included a number of international events such as Carifta and the CAC Youth Festival, where Nathan Smith captured the country's first ever gold medal at that level. As for 2014, it's expected to be another banner year, with players all vying for a spot at the Biennial Chess Olympiad this August in Norway. Well, the Bahamas Hot Rod Association is getting back into full swing thanks to its new home in the Queen Elizabeth Sports Center, and it's all about providing opportunities in a safe environment.
There's been a lot going on with the Hot Rod Association. As you can tell, we have newer facilities, and the persons have been coming out on a regular basis. They've been giving us their support. We've been having several different fanfares and several different events. Fridays every week, we have what is called import nights, usually starting from like 6:30, 7 o'clock onwards till about like 11. And on Sundays, we usually have where all of the vehicles come up, more or less the domestic vehicles, the big vehicles on alcohol, and also the import vehicles that we would have running on Fridays.
And that will do it for sports, but stay tuned, your weather forecast still to come.
This is ZNS Total Sports, brought to you by Fourth Terrace Diagnostic Center.